Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll show you how to log into Schoology and how to access the distance learning resources within our Schoology groups. This video, I will have instructions for TK6, 7th through 8th grades, and 9th through 12th grade teachers. The first thing that we're going to want to do is head over to the district website. So you're going to do that in your web browser, and you're going to go to where you type in web addresses in your web browser and head on over to www.mcsforkids.com. Once you're at our district website, all you have to do is click staff right here at the top and click staff applications. You're going to have Schoology listed right here in this column under the alphabetical order under S's. And once you've found Schoology, just click the little drop-down arrow and you get to select by your grade level. So K-8, you're going to select K-8 selection right here in this menu, and 9-12 teachers, you're going to select the 9-12. If you do not have PowerSchool for doing attendance or grades with students, then you'll have to go in through the free account. So let's log in K-8 first. So I'll click K-8. And then your login will be just your district username and password. So for me, it's going to be my last name dot first initial. It's the first part of your district email address. And then you click login. For 9-12 teachers, on this menu, you're going to select 9-12. You'll also log in with just your username and password. So that would be my last name dot first initial, just the first part of your email address and your district password, and click login. For our K-8 teachers, you're going to have to join the distance learning resource group. How you do that, you're going to go up to groups at the very top in Schoology, and towards the right hand side in that top right hand corner, click My Groups, and then you're going to click Join Group. So we'll click this button. You'll need to have an access code. And the access code to join the distance learning resource group is MTKG-NW89-MD3G3. And then once you typed in the access code, just go ahead and click join. And you have joined it. So how you'll find it in the future is once you joined it, you only join it that one time. And then to get to it, once you log into Schoology, you'll find it under groups at the very top. And you should see where it says distance learning group. If you don't see it on your grid, then just go over to My Groups. And then it's going to be an alphabetical order. So here I see it right here. I can click here and get to it from there. I can also arrange my groups grid that we were just seeing by just clicking Reorder Groups. And then I just find that group in the list. And you just hold onto it with the left mouse button and drag it all the way to the top. And then we'll close out there. So that way, next time you click Groups, it'll just be there right there at the top. So again, you get to Groups. You can click on it if it's on your grid. If not, it will be under My Groups in alphabetical order, and you just click on Distance Learning Resources. For 9-12 teachers, you are already joined to the Distance Learning Resource Group. But how do you find it? You go to Groups here at the very top in Schoology, and when you click Groups, you might see it listed right here. It would be called Distance Learning Resources. So it might be on your grid of groups that you have. But if you have a lot of groups, then it's going to be under My Groups right here. So if you click My Groups, it'll be in alphabetical order. You just find it. Here it is, Distance Learning Resources. You can always move it up throughout your list of grids if you want. You just click Reorder Groups. and you just hold down the left mouse button and drag it to the position you would want it. And then when you click groups next time, it'll be right there, easy to get to. So let me show you around this distance learning resources you have in your Schoology groups. On the left-hand side, you'll be able to click resources, and they're organized by different grade levels and subject areas. So one thing you might want to do is take a look at how to use Schoology. These are self-paced modules and courses that you can take for learning how to use Schoology. Under virtual learning best practices, when you click on that, you'll have how you can use PowerPoint to create screencasts or record your PowerPoint with narration and annotations and put those into Schoology. How to use the Wonders ELA digital book for K-6. How to use the Study Sync for 7-12, and additional resources for best practices with distance and virtual learning. In the resource area, you will also find folders broken out by grade level. So if we go into the grade level folders, you'll see there I have different subject areas that you can click on, and you'll be able to click on the grade level, and they'll be broken out by activities by different weeks. When you click on those weeks for activities, you'll see that they'll have documents for ideas for what to do on those weekly activities for that grade level and subject area. The other neat thing that you can do if you want to add these to your own Schoology courses, you can click the gear off to the right-hand side, and you can click copy to, and you can select what class in Schoology you want to copy that resource to. Let's take a look at some of the high school resources. So if I go back to resources, and let's say I look at the ELA folder, that's also broken up by subject and grade levels. So I'll go to 9-12, and let's say I go to 9th grade, and I can see there's different resources, even presentations that you can look at. So these are curated by your instructional coaches for those grade level subject areas. And again, you can view these activities, these detailed looked at what to do with distance learning for your grade level subject area. You can also add them to your Schoology courses by clicking the gear and copy to. And remember, to get to the distance learning Schoology group, log into Schoology, click groups at the very top, click your distance learning resource group, and you are there to look at all the resources that are being curated and put together for you by grade level and subject area. Thank you.